show number 55. The world is going crazy. Time to take a break. It's our favorite day. It's Sunday. It's Sunday. Whoa! It's Sunday. It's Sunday, everybody. And here we are in our downstairs.
There's that.
Studio.
Blatty noise that you don't like.
Yeah. Here we're in our downstairs studio, we like to call it now. We were upstairs, so we may go back up there. Hey, Sue, the Sues are here. A couple Sues are here. And Diane, of course. Glad you're here. Who did I see first? Who came here first? I'm going back. Tammy! Tammy Craven and Sue Werfel. Okay, there we go. All right, good to see you guys. You know what? We are going to... Jim Bonneman's here. Nice to see you. And Lorenzo, of course. Hey, where are we? Cheers. That's so far over there to get this drink. I'm going to have to go someplace else. Cheers, everybody. All right. Hey, happy Sunday. What? I got to do
this. Okay. They said they're upstairs, kind of tone it down a little bit.
Tone it down, they said. Okay, I'm good.
Getting a little loud.
Had to get my wine in an easier
they're
place.
They're like renters, these.
Okay, we're going to start off. Hey, Rita and Aurelia, everyone. We're going to start off right away with the song that Johnny Nash did, and Diane, you asked for it, so here we go.
Show on TV. Remember you asked for it?
I can see clearly. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. That's right, Lorenzo, Johnny Nash. I think I can make it now, the pain is gone. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. Look all around, there's nothing but blue sky. Look straight ahead, there's nothing but blue Well, it was snowing. It was snowing out a few minutes ago here, so
that's like funky reggae.
I love that song.
That was a great beat. That was a great beat of that song.
Hey, right? You know what, Diane? Thanks for asking for that one.
Diane, thank you.
Yeah, she's good. What the heck's going on? Yeah, we've got a nice mixture of songs, I think, today, don't you, Dominic?
Yeah.
You didn't, Dominic. You didn't. You were too busy looking at your keyboard. Come on. Do a toast for everybody.
Yeah.
Happy hour here on Sundays. with our dear friends. Love to see you, Susie Monty. Snow flurries, yes, and gloomy. It is pretty gloomy here. And the Mallons are here from Roger and Kathy all the way from Pennsylvania. Love to see you guys.
Susie shortened her name. Susie Monty Woolley. Remember Monty Woolley?
Nope.
Did I ever bring his name up?
No.
Oh, he's in a million movies from the 30s and 40s.
No, I don't know him, Dominic. Did you toast?
Monty Wiley.
Did you raise your
Monty?
Did you raise your glasses to our people?
Woolley. Monty Woolley. Oh, it used to be Woolley Monty.
Mary Berg is here. Hey, that's good. I got a call from the Jaycotts today, and, you know, they've been married for...
The Earl of Jaycotts.
I believe it's 66 years, if I'm right. Am I right, Jaycotts?
Whoa.
Oh, that was Marley. He's jumping around.
Yeah, he's about to play the
66
tambourine.
Years. They're going to come on May 2nd also. Oh, look at some people got tickets. I saw Betty Rydell said she's going to be at May 2nd for her Best of Broadway show.
Betty was up front last year.
Belting
show.
Babes of Broadway. We're going to be doing that at Crooners next Sunday. And I'm not sure it's going to be streaming, so if you can make it up there, do it. I'm going to try and get it streamed, even if I have to put my own darn little phone up front for it. But we'll see. But I'm so glad you guys are coming. And guess what? I was talking to Earl and Elvira. And we met so many, many years ago, and one of their favorite songs is a song that Nat King Cole originally did, and then Natalie Cole did a version of it, too. And we're going to do it for you right now. We're going to do it, well, it's kind of Natalie Cole's version, if I would say. So here you go. This is for the Jaycotts.
They're both Nat Cole.
However many, yeah, that's right.
Both of them are
however many years you're married. I think it's 66, though. So here we go. Goodbye. No use leading with our chins. This is where our story ends. Never lovers, ever friends. Goodbye. But before you walk away, I sincerely want to say I wish you to give your heart a song to sing, and then a kiss. But more than this, I wish you love, and in July a lemonade to cool you in some leafy. I wish you health, but more than well, I wish you love. My breaking heart, and I grieve that you and I can never be. So with my best, my very best, I'll set you free. I wish you shelter from the storm, a cozy fire to keep you warm. But most of all, when snowflakes fall, I wish you love. But most of all,
snowflakes fall, I wish you love.
Fun singing that one. Thank you, Earl and Elvira. I love singing stuff like that. You can probably tell. Oh my gosh. I think it's you're up already, Dominic.
I am.
Dominic's up already, and he loves his song because it reminds you of what?
Wow, it reminds me of my old gearhead days, I guess.
Your gearhead days. Okay, out with it. I'm going to show you what it reminds him of. Where is it?
It reminds me of my 67 Malibu.
Right his 67. You had
that's what's
you,
left of it.
You actually had a 67.
I blew it up.
A 67 Malibu.
I blew it up on the Dan Ryan.
There it is.
Like
that's Dominic's car. He had it in the small machine. Oh. Shrunk it. One of those things. Susie Matzik, thank you. Thank you. Nancy Keys. Hi, Nancy.
This car was
from
a
Edina,
goer,
Minnesota. Thank you so much, Nancy. Appreciate it.
425 horsepower.
Yeah. Oh, and you know, we're going to do this song. It's a Jan and Dean song. Jan and Dean. And you're going to be playing the
part. This is the car racing song.
It really is.
Time. It's the epic.
It is. And are you going to be play the part of Dean or Jan?
I'm going to be playing the part of the dead guy.
Oh, okay.
He's talking to the doc just before he dies, I think.
All right.
Right before he takes his last breath.
Okay, here we go.
I'm trying to do a nice job on that.
It's a little bit of Jan and Dean for you here on this Sunday afternoon to cheer you all up.
I was cruising in my Stingray late one night when an XKE pulled up on the right. He rolled down the window of a shiny new Jag and challenged me there and then to a threat. I said, "Your own body, but the mill's on fine. Yes, I come on the line at sunset and back. I'll do you one better if you got the nerve. Let's race all the way to Dead Man's Cove. Deserted on a Friday night. We were bugging each other when we sat out the light. Pop up the clutch when the light turned green. You should have heard the whine from my screaming machine. I pooped at La Brea and Crescent Heights. All the Jag could see was my six tail light. Passed me a Doheny and I started to swerve. Then I pulled her out. The dead man's dirt.
The last thing I remember, Doc, I started to swerve. Then I saw the Jag sliding into the curb. I know I won't forget that horrible sight. Found out for myself, everyone was right.
You won't come back from Dead Man's Curve. The high part is so good. A Dead Man's Curve. Dead Man's Curve. Won't come back from Dead Man's Curve. Dead Man's Curve. Dead Man's Curve. Mr. Dead Man's Curve. You let me go away. Dead Man's Curve. I can hear him say. Won't come back from Dead Man's Curve.
Yeah!
Never change the arrangement.
There
the hour before the show. There we go.
Wheelies.
Oh, Kathy Merle's here. That's somebody. Hey, Deacon Marty Kulak is here.
He liked that one. He likes Carhead.
Oh, of course he does. Feeling the summertime hits, he says. Feeling them good. All right. What? Just a minute. I kind of got to get myself together. We've got... It doesn't feel like that's right to come, because Mary Berg, you asked for this next one that's coming up. And you asked for it a while ago, I might add. And it happens to be a Peter, Paul, and Mary song written by none other than
one of the weathermen.
Bob Dylan.
Channel 11.
Bob Dylan wrote this.
Oh, yeah.
That's right. And you should be wearing a...
He asks many questions in this song, and I can answer them all, but she won't let me.
Dominic, you should be wearing your toupee in this one.
My toupee. Oh, yeah.
Why did we think of that?
Reminds me.
Why did we think of that?
I'll have to tell the folks about it right after the song.
Yeah. Here we go. And we're gonna do this one. Of course, Peter, Paul, and Mary, we all love them. And, of course, Bob Dylan. What a poet. And, you know, as I'm singing this, I'm going, oh, Blown in the Wind, Hootenanny. But actually, it's a great song. It's really great.
Hootenanny.
Yes. Rainy Funk. We like that. Rainy Funk.
She wants Feral. To hear some funk?
Her maiden name is Funk. Isn't that great?
That's great.
That is a great name. Rainy Funk. You could be like a rap singer.
You could be a hip-hop singer, Rainy. Genre of music.
Hey, I'm Rainy Funk.
No, that's a genre nowadays. Rainy Funk. It's like funk that makes you cry.
Oh.
By Parliament.
We love Peter, Paul, and Mary. And here we go with these great words that can apply, I'm telling you, right today. Don't you think? Here we go.
Getting my 12-string tuned up.
Oh. It's a hootenanny, everybody. Sing along.
How many roads must a man walk down before they call him a man? How many seas must a white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand? How many times must the cannonballs fly before they're forever banned? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. How many years must a mountain exist before it is washed to the sea? How many years can some people exist before they're allowed to be free? How many times can a man turn his head and pretend that he just doesn't see? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. How many times must a man look up before he can see the sky? And how many ears must one man have before he can hear people cry? How many deaths will it take till he knows that too many people have died? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
Colleen, that was beautiful. But I have to tell you something. You know what else was blowing in the wind this morning?
It was windy.
It was really windy. I opened the door and I got hit in the face with a toupee.
Bada boom. I should bring a little.
You know, I got to tell you, I met Bob Dylan once. And I said, Bob, I got, you know, all those questions you were asking in Blown in the Wind? Well, I did some research, and I got answers to all of them. How many years? The whole thing.
Yeah,
I know. Exactly.
When we started rehearsing.
14 years.
When we started practicing this, I said, you're not going to do that in the song. Because I started singing, I go,
so I did,
how many times must the cannonballs fly before they're forever banned?
26.
How many years does a mountain exist before it is washed to the sea?
9.
How? He kept doing that, and I was trying to sing it. God dang it.
Oh, right. I was just answering the questions. You know, I want to get on Jeopardy so bad.
You guys.
I'm going to be like the worst loser of all time. Minus 8,000, and I'm going to bet real big, too.
Did you guys see, what's his name, Aaron, you know, the football player. I can't think of his name.
Aaron, Elvis Aaron Presley?
No. Oh. The quarterback from the Packers.
Oh, Aaron, Rodgers.
Yeah.
Like Roy Rodgers.
Aaron,
is he
related, did you see that? Aaron Rodgers was host on Jeopardy. He's a brainiac. I knew he was smart, but there he was, Aaron Rodgers. Doing it. Okay, what do we got coming up next? Oh, of course, I have to get this out for you, because whenever we come up with anything that has to do with the king,
yeah.
Susie, my cousin, loves this. It's getting to look a little bit. His eyes look pretty good, even if you don't like the rest of them. Elvis did this.
Is that fat Elvis or skinny Elvis or what?
Mid-sized Elvis.
Remember Fat Elvis? He was my favorite.
Like a mid-sized car.
I love Fat Elvis.
Okay, we're going to get to the next one. This is an Elvis song. And Nesta said, can you do this one? I said,
Nesta said it?
Yeah, she did.
She's
ask
such
for this.
An Elvis
But
fan.
I got to say that Susie and I, as we were growing up and running around Prescott, we loved Elvis. And, of course, this album was so huge. This album also had, do you know what other song, big song was on here besides What I'm Gonna Do? I can't help falling in love with you. Wise men say. I just did that a couple of weeks ago. Same album. And the movie came out in like 1961. Did you know that?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, wait a minute. You know,
I have a hit record, too, called I Can't Help Eating Pasta on Sundays.
We forgot.
And I'll do it again today.
You know what we forgot to say about Dead Man's Curve, because we kind of got distracted? That, you know, Dead Man's Curve is just some street in Beverly Hills, right?
No, it's a,
it's a, they use, yeah, it's a, yeah, it's an intersection.
It's Sunset.
Yeah.
That street.
And Jan, whatever his last name is.
Jan,
whatever his.
Barry.
Is that
Jan
his name?
Barry.
Jan Barry.
Barry, yes.
He ended up getting a car accident and dying only two blocks from there. And it's not even.
Well, first of all, there is no Dead Man's Curve. If
no,
it wasn't
well, they called it that.
He's
yeah.
the guy who called it Dead Man's Curve.
And then he died at it. Dun, 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 dun.
What a prophecy.
That is so weird, isn't it?
You know
it?
What else? Lincoln had a secretary named Kennedy. And Kennedy had a secretary named.
Yeah, we know.
Trump.
Okay, here we go. We're onward to the Elvis song from Blue Hawaii.
Night and you and Blue Hawaii. And you are heaven to me. Lovely and blue Hawaii. With all this loveliness, there should be love. Come with in blue or white. And mine could all come true this magic night of night.
There we go. What year do you think that movie came out? Just what year? What year do you think?
2009.
No, it was in 61. So I would have been 9 years old when that came out. Oh, all my cousins. My cousin Sharon Johnson from up in White Bear, that was far away for a cousin, I'll tell you, back then. She had all of Elvis's albums, every one of them. I remember looking at them. I didn't have hardly any albums. As a farm girl, I didn't have that stuff. All right. Somebody is writing, it's a mountain pass between, I don't know who's writing, it's on blue. Somebody's sending stuff, but it's in this blue thing, and I can't tell who it is. So, but it's so nice to see you. Love Peter, Paul, and Mary we got there. Let me go back here. You know what else I saw in here was Deb Brown. I saw Deb Brown on here, which she and Brian had did one whole year of Sunday afternoons right after us, and we watched their show, their last one last week. Remember, Dominic? Those guys, so talented.
Yeah,
so
really
darn
good.
Talented.
Excellent.
All right. Hey, Mary Jane, did you notice our
well, this is
art
right
in the background?
Mary Jane's alley.
Yeah, Mary Jane
Except
is an artist. Mary Jane Pollock. And actually, this design back there, that's a big... linen backdrop that Reed Graham, for those of you who know Greed, he did a song called We Are Creating Now and did a video. And as they were doing the video, We Are Creating Now. It was a great song. If you haven't heard it, look it up. Reed Graham, We Are Creating Now. Anyway, and they were throwing paint and painting stuff during the video. And this is what that is
Left
in the background.
Over.
No, it's all of it. It's the whole thing there, but you can't see it all. It's huge. On the floor, it's everywhere, it's big.
It's
and then,
psychedelic,
of course,
man.
That is not Dominic's artwork there. That would be Picasso. No. That I found. Yeah, you never know what you can find around here. And of course, the sun, which I like to stand right in front of like this.
It's psychedelic.
So it looks
dude.
Like I have the rays coming out of my head. Colleen Raye. How about that? Good? You like it? It's hilarious. Come on. All right. Well, at least to me it is. I have to have another drink before we start this song. I'm having to reach too far for my wine today. Hold that for me for a second, would you?
Yeah.
Just for a second. Pulling this over here so I don't have to be...
You're going to sit on a stool?
I don't want to stretch. No. I don't have to stretch so far to reach my drink. And I don't want to have to go like this in front of you every time I go and get it.
Why don't you just get a hose type thing?
I should get one of those little hats that have the straws coming in.
What did we have the day when we were getting stuff
Cheers,
filled?
Everybody! Happy hour on Sunday.
We were getting our glasses automatically filled. That was Joe Morrissey. Mm-hmm. I just remembered.
That's right. Joe did that. Okay. So Deacon Marty Kulak, who is the most relatable deacon of all time, as we know, why isn't this scrolling up? This is not scrolling up like it usually does. So I can't see them as they're coming in. I'm having to do it manually. Susie loved it. She loved the thing. Pete. Oh, Pete is the one who's... It's a mountain pass between... L.A. in the San Francisco Valley, straight down 200 or 300 feet, deadly. That's what he says Dead Man's Curve is. So there, Pete Elmeroth, your buddy. Wow,
oh.
I'm missing all these things on here.
Was that on one of your trips, Pete?
one of his... Oh, my God. See, I'm going to catch up here. I'm getting you guys.
His head's a little soggy. He was in the submarine service.
Anyway, so Deacon Marty Kulak from Ellsworth, St. Francis Parish, Ellsworth, Wisconsin, wanted me to know if we could do this one. I said, why not for you, Marty? Anything. So we're going to do, what do you call this kind of music, Dominic? Psychedelic?
What do we got here?
Would you call psychedelic?
Oh, yeah.
Psychedelic music. And I happen to have had this album, Marty.
I just want to wake you up.
I had this album, Marty, so I'm going to crank it up even. We're going to get it nice and loud.
Yeah, if you're tripping, this one will knock.
Get ready. Get your wine ready. Here we are. Finally. Ow! Getting near dawn, when light shines eyes on you, I'll soon be with you, my love, to give you my dawn surprise. I'll be with you, darling, soon. I'll be with you when the stars start falling. I've been waiting so long to be where I'm going, in the sunshine of your love. I'm with you, my love, the light shining through on you. Yeah, I'm with you, my love. Morning and just we two. I'll stay with you, darling, now. I'll stay with you till my seas are dried up. I've been waiting so long to be where I'm going, in the sunshine of your love.
Turn it up.
Shining through all you. Yeah, I'm with you, my love. It's the morning and just we two. I'll stay with you, darling, now. I'll stay with you till my tears are dried up. I've been waiting so long. I've been waiting so long. I've been waiting so long to be where I'm going, in the sunshine of your love. Far
out. Far out, man.
Oh, sorry, Dom. I forgot to crank you for that one.
Far out.
Sounded good back there.
Where's my wig?
Everybody was saying...
I was doing my arthritis laden Rick Wakeman.
Everybody was saying, groovy. Wow. Groovy. Everybody was saying, Eric Clapton, because he's the one who did the big guitar solo which
sorry,
we did
Eric.
Not have.
Which we didn't have that, so we had to put a Rick Wakeman style.
We have a song that is, this is pretty fun because the guy that sang it, Tommy James, but that wasn't his real name, he's from Indiana, not far from you guys, right, Dominic?
Not far at all.
Down there at South Bend or something? South Bend, was it?
He's from Michigan, but that's close, too.
I thought he said...
Niles, I think. He's from Niles, Michigan.
Oh, he is? I thought it was Indiana.
No, he's from Michigan.
Oh, okay.
That's close, too.
Anyway, he was only like 12 or 13, Tommy James and the Shondells, when he had his first recording contract and everything. And they ended up having this, they were doing a recording session. They had an extra 20 minutes left. So they thought, oh, let's do something. So they ended up writing this song in, the guys that wrote it in like 20 minutes, right? And they played it, and it really didn't become like a big hit right away the first time they recorded it. But some DJ in Cincinnati started playing it, and it just caught on. Then another radio station in Cincinnati played it. Another radio in Cincinnati played it. He became a huge star in Cincinnati. Yeah. The funny thing was, by this time, the band had broken up, and they really weren't doing anything. And he was like working. Plus, he got kind of sick of being a star. I think.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Well, the song didn't become a hit because they said the lyrics were so complicated that people couldn't figure it out. You know?
Right. So anyway, in Cincinnati, so they did this. He was a huge. I mean, he was a craze over there. So he gets a phone call. They said, "Can you come and do a concert in Cincinnati for us? Sing this song in Cincinnati," and he didn't have a band, so he had to go over to Cincinnati and just pick up some guys, learn the song, and do it in Cincinnati. But what was funny is he said he went from literally, and then he was a big star after that, until a few years later, which he was only about 19 or 20, he couldn't take the stardom anymore. But he became so famous so fast. He said he was, the night before that, he was working in a little bar for 20 people in wherever he was. And then the next night, it was 10,000 screaming. I mean, like screaming fans like the Beatles.
Poetry fans.
And that song was beating out all sorts of people for the Grammy Awards. And who did they beat out, Dominic, you were saying? The Animals or something, or the Kinks? Oh, you saw the Kinks.
Oh, no. Well, everybody in Chicago knows WCFL. And remember they used to have the bands in on Saturday morning, and they'd be performing in the lobby of the building downtown that was in, and Tommy James and Shondells were there, and they were surprised. I remember surprised that their song was doing so well. They came by and did a show at 10 o'clock,
and they were bigger than the Kinks.
They were bigger
than the Kinks.
Oh, they drew more than the Kinks.
Oh, absolutely. And you know what else? We're here in Little Ellsworth, Wisconsin, which has only 3,000 people in it, and we have a dance place here that was well known everywhere. Right, Janice? You remember. Janice Ottman is here. Approaches Popular Ballroom. And yes, he was here.
And Tommy was
Tommy here. James and the Shondell. Of course, Sam the Sham and the Pharaohs. Everybody was there. Yeah. It was a big deal. Right in our little hometown.
Well, there's a guy out now named James Tommy. He actually...
You're kidding.
No.
He's making up stuff.
It's James
Thomas. So here we go.
James Thomas.
You guys, you know how many times?
James Thomas.
Here's the song. Here's the Tommy James and the Shondells big hit that made him world famous. And we all know the words because the main phrase is said no less than 23 times in it. Right?
Sir. My baby does the hanky panky. 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 My baby does the hanky panky.
For John Davies.
My baby does the hanky panky. 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 I saw her walking on down the line. You know I saw her for the very first time. A pretty little girl standing all alone. Hey, pretty baby, can I take you home?
I never saw her, never, never saw her. My baby does the hanky panky.
My baby does the hanky panky. My baby does the hanky panky. My baby does the hanky.
You got that?
My baby does the hanky panky.
I saw her walking on down the line. You know I saw her for the very first time. A pretty little girl standing all alone. Pretty baby, can I take you home? You never saw her, never, never saw her.
My baby does the hanky panky.
My baby does the hanky panky.
My baby does the hanky panky. My baby does the hanky panky. My baby does the hanky panky.
You know, Colleen, I saw you after rehearsal the other day writing down these lyrics. She was writing on them. She's going,
23 times, 23 times. Hey, Susan Ottman, she loved that. Oh, no. Wait a minute. Okay, here we go.
This is a very popular song, you know, it was.
It was so popular. It was super swinging. You want to hear the song swinging, or do you like that? It was a swinging song. Is that what you're saying? I can't, this show's going too fast. It feels like it's really, really fast. Oh, no, it's not that fast. It's just that we got so much going on here.
It's half fast.
By the way, John Davies asked for that. He has a party hits. I've known John for quite a few years. He lives up in Eau Claire, and he is a disc jockey.
He likes that one.
He loves it. He knows it's a party hit. Disc jockey. He has a DJ is what he has. He has the most elaborate setup with the best lights and the best sound.
You know what he said after he heard that? He said, they said hanky panky.
Anyway, John. Listen, if you guys need a DJ for anything, I'm not kidding you. He is so reasonable and so professional. The best party hits. Free advertising, John. Party hits up in Eau Claire area. You'll find him. John, you'll love him too. He's a sweetheart. So now, Dominic, remember we were talking to Tammy, at least we're talking back to Tammy Craven?
Tammy Craven? My sister Tammy?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Well, my sister Tammy? Damn it!
He tries to talk like a DJ right
now. Well, nobody can talk like John Davies. He's got that low voice.
No, he doesn't.
He shakes.
He doesn't even know John. Socks. Did you say socks? Is that what that says? I hope that's what it
says. S-O-X. Are they winning?
Socks win.
Socks win. That's Jerome, I bet.
No, Lorenzo.
Oh, Lorde.
Lorenzo.
Yeah, boy, last night was good, wasn't it, Lorde?
But Tammy Craven was asking for a song, and it was just something I never heard of. And we're getting kind of busy, so it's hard for me to learn new songs. Really hard for me to learn new songs. No.
Well, Hanky Panky took you forever.
We're trying to fit these in. Everything
well, she
in,
says,
right?
What's the next word here? And I said,
we were talking.
Hanky is the next word, all right?
And we said that
Panky's right after that.
Dominic is going to pick out a song. Well, we both did. We picked this out kind of together and thought that you would like it because I know you kind of like country music a little bit. And
I do.
Carrie Underwood, I know you like big ballads, and plus I was watching the American Country Music Awards, or whatever that was the other night, anyway, and they had a big gospel thing with Carrie Underwood and all the singers singing a fabulous, fabulous thing. And this one was kind of snuck in there a little bit, but Carrie Underwood has such a fantastic version of it. I thought that we thought that, Tammy, you would like this. So here we go. And by the way, this is for Helen and Don, too.
Consider all the worlds thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God, his Son not sparing, sent him to die, I scarce can take it in. That on that cross, my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation, take me home. What joy shall fill my heart? Then I shall bow in humble adoration, and then proclaim.
Good one. Good song.
You know,
I couldn't help, you know, you were talking about Tammy, and I couldn't help think about Jerry and how, you know, he's kind of happy. He had to have a surgery, but that's the bad part of it. But the good part of it is he gets to wear a patch over his eye and act like a pirate all day and get away. He's, you know, this is the kind of stuff Jerry, you know, I play golf with him, and, you know, he sits in the cart and pretends he's a pirate. And, you know, arr, that was a good putt. Arr, 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 arr.
Hey, everybody, like that song. Oh, wasn't that? That was, I know, Carrie Underwood's arrangement of that is fabulous. The first time I heard it, I just went,
she arranged it?
Well, the arrangement she uses. Oh. It's pretty fantabulous, for sure. What else do we have here that we... Let me see if I forgot to say anything. Oh, okay. I want to remind you guys that May 2nd, which is next May, I mean next Sunday, I literally am hyperventilating from that song. I'm going to have some wine. Cheers, everyone. By the way, thank you guys. We still have another song yet. Thank you for watching.
You're hyperventilating from the Cream song.
I might be still. That's a lot to do.
That's it.
I'm sitting down. That's why my chin's all... I said, I'll sit down for a minute. Elvis sang that too. You're right, Sue. He did. So many people did. I looked at it, but I'll tell you what. Carrie Underwood's arrangement is the best yet. But anyway, thank you guys for the tips and the notes and the letters you're sending in the mail and the little emails and things.
The requests.
The requests, of course. We love that. Okay, and for sharing with other people. It's always nice to share. We appreciate that. And, we love that. And then, like I said, next Sunday, May 2nd, we're going to be at Crooners. The show doesn't start until 5. I'm hoping that it will be streamed, or I'll try and get it streamed. And if you want to come to Crooners, they have the best food, and the doors open at 4 o'clock, and you can have dinner. It's like a supper club. I'm not kidding you. And they have, we're behind plexiglass, but you can't tell. And they have HEPA filters and a high ceiling, and they have limited seating. But it is
but
just
But you know
great.
What they really have there is my favorite burger.
Oh, yeah.
Anywhere. Okay, now, it's a really good burger. It's really good. I don't know what that means. But it's really good. But on top of that, they put a couple of short ribs on top of it.
Short ribs on a burger.
On top of the burger.
Yeah, gotta love it.
I love both of those things, and I just said, oh, my God.
Well, yeah, Tammy
not
said...
Not the long ribs.
Tammy said that her dad would say, drink more wine, so...
He would.
That's what we're going to do.
He'd probably say beer.
We, you know, my brother Dickie watches this every week, which I appreciate, and then we talk about it, and he tells me which one he likes the best and everything. It's so much fun. We talk almost every day, my big brother and I. Isn't that sweet? I love it.
They dish the dirt.
We dish the dirt, baby. And, I love it. And this is a song that we used to do a Motown medley. Remember that, Dominic? No, you weren't with us when we did that. You were gone.
Yeah, I made sure I was. No.
That was a good medley. That's why I kind of
is
knew
that
this.
The one they call the Schmedley?
Nope.
No.
Oh. Nope. Oh, well, here, you're going to like this one. And the Malins got a few requests in, but it was like a little too late to put them in for this week. But I'm telling you, Kathy and Roger, I think you're going to like this one. And everybody sing along.
Don't we have a group with us on this one?
Oh, we do.
Help. We got it. Oh.
Okay. Here we go. See if we recognize it.
Mind. Honey, honey,
but these tears I can't hold inside. Losing you and my life, you see, 'cause you mean that much to me. You could have told me yourself that you love somebody else. Oh no, I heard it through the grapevine. Not much longer would you be mine.
You know what else came from the grapevine?
That was a mess.
This wine came from the grapevine.
That I thought I was going to do a really good job on that. Then I forgot to come in after the solo. Cheers. Here we go. And then we started over. And that
didn't
help.
Marvin used to screw
and I'm
that
sweating.
Up all the time, too.
I'm literally sweating. Okay, maybe I need some. See, I'm talking into my wine glass. Did you see that? I want maybe. What's going on? Okay, that's all there is to it. I'm taking a glucose tablet right now. Here we are. My sugar, blood sugar's low.
That looked like a Necco, or what are those things?
It's a glucose tablet.
It looks like one of those Neccos, or whatever they call them.
My blood sugar's dropping. I can feel it. That's what was happening there. I'm not kidding. You feel my neck, Dominic? It's hot.
I slid right off of that baby. Holy crap. You can water ski on that.
Oh, come
neck.
On, Denise. You didn't just see that awful thing I just did. I hope you... Denise Tomasello's here. I hope that
no.
you...
No.
Denise, I hope you
from
saw...
From Atlantic City?
I hope you saw how great you are. From Chicago.
Didn't we know her from Atlantic City, though?
No, Chicago. And anyway, thank you, everybody, for watching.
Sorry,
we appreciate
Denise.
It so much. We will be back. Next week, you're... Next week, we are going to be up at Crooner's, so that's what we said there. And thank you so much. On Mother's Day, we're going to be down at Aurelia's in Chicago, having so much fun. I can't wait to do that. And keep it up, and I'm going to take my glucose tablets a little bit earlier next time. Thank you so much. Are you vamping us for the last song, please?
All right. You got to turn me up if you want to hear it.
Okay, there we go. You kind of... The California raisins hurt you, I'll tell you. Okay, here we go, and we will see you next week from Crooners. Love you guys. Bye-bye. The world is going crazy. Time to take a break. It's our day to play. It's Sunday. It's Sunday. Whoa. It's Sunday. everybody. We appreciate you all so much. Thanks.